Hello, bit of a different start to a feeding video, I know. I think this is huge feeding video. Sorry if I look away from the camera, because that's me looking at the camera, but that's me looking at the screen, so I will just look at the screen, it makes it easier for me. This feeding video is pretty naff. I'm going to be honest, a lot of teas seem to be in pre-malt. But it's an update of my collection, so that's why it's still here. I think there's only one feeding video I've never put up, and it was like when I had like 40s and non eight. So yeah. There were a few good takedowns, that's why I've kept it all in, and it is an update. But just to warn you, my flash goes off near the end, so for about 10 clips I have no flash because my phone overheated, and for about 5 clips there's no audio, so I am warning you now, it's not the best quality feeding video, but I had a lot of problems and I've been ill, so sorry about that. Look at the camera again, sorry. But yeah, so the collection's doing fine, no deaths, so I'm just gonna let the theme video roll, but that's all I'm saying. Sorry that the flash went off at about 10 clips, and for about 5 clips I didn't talk. So sorry about that. I have been ill, so sorry about that. This is just to show you what I will look like as well. There's quite a few new subs and they don't know what I look like, so yeah, this is me. Also, I've been. Someone said to me, I should put my frogs in my feeding video. What do people think about that? It had about 5 minutes to every feeding video. So, if you want my frogs in the feeding video, thumbs up, let's say that. If you want my frogs to be in the feeding video, just thumbs up or make a comment and thumb up, or whatever it's called. I don't know. But yeah. Just write in the comment section, that'll make it easier. Yeah, I'm babbling on anyway. So I'm gonna cut to the theme video, and yeah. Sorry, not many things ate. So it, people, bye. Hello, and welcome to huge theme video 14, I think. I'm gonna f usually my El Klugi would get a adult locust, but I've only got one left. Because I've just fed the scorpions, and if I'm honest, I don't think she's gonna eat anyway. She didn't eat last week, and that's a bit odd. So I do think she's in pre-malt. If you do look at her abdomen though, it does look pretty dark. So she could be in pre-malt. So let's see if she eats. Yeah, as you can see, all she did was like kick her legs forward, and that's what my. Is there a fly? That's what my Bomia did before that molted. There's a fly flying around, which you know, it's just gone in. It's not like the substrate's wet, so it's not like to the arm. If I'm honest, I might give a deeper substrate when she molts. But for now, she's fine. But yeah, I knew she wouldn't eat. So yeah, El Klugi. I'm gonna start using names in videos. Just I like my names, what I call them. So it's Valkyrie, the Lassie Adora Klugi. So I'll leave her be. Confirmed female, especially from the size and bulk. So yeah, we'll leave her be. Okay, back in a sec. Next we have my freshly molted Lassie Adora Parahibana. It is unnamed, but it is a suspect male. I don't think I'll be able to tempt it out. But it's quite hard to do, especially with locusts. Nope, not going to notice it. Nope. Well, I know for a fact. Noticed it. Well, it has noticed it. No, I can't see anything. Can't see it too well.
I'll come back to this one. I won't be able to get it on camera. It's quite awkward to do. She does stay at the back. When the juvies to sub adults, they are quite skittish and elusive, whatever you want to call it, reclusive. I can't remember the word. But yeah, just keep to themselves. So I'll leave her be and move on to the next one. Back in a sec. This is my Pamphibetus adult female. Yet to catch this one actually eating on camera, so let's see if she's hungry. I can get the locust stuff to tell them. Proper pussy, this Pamphibetus species. Pamphibetus 40, I don't know if it's actual one. But yeah, it's a proper pussy. It's definitely in pre-molt, as you can see the abdomen's beige colour. Just give it a sec. Proper pussy. Don't get why. Because she's absolutely huge. Get stuck in there. I don't know why it's so scared. It used to eat roaches, if I'm correct. Well, don't like it's gonna eat. Don't understand why. I'll leave it be. I'm gonna leave the locust in for a bit. I know you don't usually do that with my adults, but I'm gonna leave it until the end of the video. If it's unedited, just take it out. So yeah, I'll leave it be. Bit odd that she's still not eating, but it's not like she's skinny, is it? So I can't complain. Okay, back in a sec.
As per usual, I don't show you my vicular area later, it's just at the back, just behind where my finger is, like there. You can see the leg a tiny bit. But yeah, doing perfectly fine. First ever vicular area sling I've had, and it's doing perfectly fine. So yeah, we'll move on to the next one. Back in a sec. This is my Vicularia species Peru Purple. I'm naturally going to feed it because I pretty much know for a fact it's in pre-molt. can't see it too well. But yeah, it's pretty confident that it's in pre-molt. So I'm not going to feed it. Plus it's not like it's got a small abdomen, so it's well fed. But yeah, it's in suspect's pre-molt. It hadn't ate for about 4-6 weeks now, so I'm just gonna leave it be. Don't see the point in stressing it out. So yeah, move on to the next one. Back in a sec. I forgot to mention the Pamphibetus fortis. But yeah, that's called Phoenix. The Vicularia later is unnamed, and the Peru purple is unnamed as well. I like to sex juvies before I name them. Slings sometimes get random names, but yeah. Okay, move on to the next one. Back in a sec. I just had to put some pipette, some water into its bowl down there, and it's had to come out. So I just thought I'd actually show you. It's because as you can see, the abdomen is. It's darkening at the moment, but it's very similar to the aiming actrix, the abdomen, and overall a very nice tarantula. Really, really happy that I got this as a grown on juvie. And we'll just leave it be. I'll just do it showing you because it's actually come out. It's very reclusive, but most juvie avix are, to my knowledge. Okay, we'll leave it be and move on to the next one properly this time. Okay, back in a sec. I've just took the locust out of the Pamphibetus fortis's tank because it's just walked. It's basically been in the hide and walked back out, so I very much doubt it's going to eat. It's not like it's got a small abdomen, so I'm not worried at all. It just might not be hungry.
because it has got a very fat abdomen, it was very well fed. So I'll just leave it be. Can't complain really. It's webbing up a lot and it seems to be happy, so yeah. I'll move on to the next one. Back in a sec. Just thought I'd give an update on my Campuscuria Aatrox. The reason I don't give an update on my Viculeira later as a lot is it likes to climb out a lot, but this one no trouble, just because it's burrowed down there. I've just watered it, so the substrate's a bit damp. But yeah, I need to crush that properly. I just dropped it in bags. Yeah, I'll crush that and I'll leave it be. It's doing perfectly fine though. Okay, back in a sec. This is my Cryopodromus puriscal. I did buy it as a Cryopodromus species, but I know who they got it from, so I know it's a Cryopodromus puriscal. Or species puriscal, whatever. I'll drop this in, but I know it's going to probably go for it straight away, because it is a really good eater. I ain't crushed the head on it this time, because I know it's a good eater. Hopefully, it'll go for it. It is down there somewhere. There's my pipette. So. Just trying to get it into the burrow. Locust. Never want to do what I want them to do. I'm going to push the head, makes my life so much easier. I'm just going to leave that like that. I'll give you an update, but I know for a fact this one will eat. Yeah, it's absolutely amazing how much it eats. It's proper tank. Really good sling. I'd advise it to anyone, because I got told they're a bit iffy, but if I'm honest, I have no problems with this sling. I do need to water it. I'll just put the lid on for now. It is. I know it's in there, just such a leg. Oh, it's there. Just climbed up the side. Okay, I'll leave it be and move on to the next one. Back in a sec. This is my Gramostol amphrosina. Quite a good eater. I'm having no problems with this, just a very, very slow grower. As you can see, it's skittish, but it usually does eat. I'm going to leave it be, I don't want to stress out too much. But yeah, a very nice little sling. Should start darkening up a bit in a couple of months. It is darkening slowly, and it's got a very fat abdomen, so it is a very good eater. I'm going to leave it be and move on to the next one. Sorry that I'm starting with stuff that it doesn't seem to eat, but I can never predict what's going to eat and what's not going to eat, and I prefer to do. I prefer to show all my tarantulas just to give an update. Okay, back in a sec. I will be keeping a lid on this one because this is my Holophila Inti Gold, and it's called Abra for a reason. It wants to teleport. It is very, very fast. It worries me how quick this tarantula is. The speed it is growing, I do think it's a male. It's not mature just yet. It doesn't look it. No, it's not mature. Don't look at least. No, it's not. So yeah, all I've done is chuck the locus in, and I know it'll go for it. I might actually just wait a second and record this. Sorry if I seem a bit off. I'm ill today. I have put it off for a day, but I do like to feed them and water them. Well, water them weekly and feed them every 2 weeks. So I've just got on top of it and trying to do it now. It's not too bad, it don't bother me doing it at all. But yeah, we'll see if it does anything. It is a really skittish species. Holophilas are in general, but in my experience, this one is just 10 times skittish compared to my Inti and my Sanguiniceps. I'm just going to leave it be, to be fair. I'll give you an update on that, but I know for a fact it's going to eat. Yeah, sorry about this. Not many things eating, but I'm going to move on to some adults now, and then move back on to some muslings. Well, I think I'll move down the sizes now. I might feel my GBP. Yeah, I will. Okay, so I'm just going to leave them be, and back in a sec. Just before I feed her, I'm just going to show you how calm my GBB is. Look at that. She just like, she used to be like this before she molted, then she got really moldy for a bit. But as you can see, she's just hungry. She's really, really calm. I really like her. As you can see, she's just hungry. Nothing wrong with her at all. See, she's doing a little fret posture, but it's not striking, nothing. Just completely lethargic, and I'm happy about that. I will be feeding her, just give me a second, and I'll just grab a locust. Back in a sec. So I'm just going to drop this in, I know she's going to eat it, she's an awesome eater. So let's see what she does. Still mean? Straight away. But yeah, she's generally calm, she webbed up an absolute ton. She used to have a hammock there, but she destroyed it. And she likes to sit on the floor now. But yeah, very good weather, very good species. I was put off by these for a long time, but because I thought they'd be very vicious, but I bought an absolutely calm and docile one. Some of them can be a bit skittish, but generally, there's nothing wrong with mine. It's completely docile though. So yeah, I will leave it be, and I'll move on to the next one. Back in a sec. This is my Nandu Chromatis, doing perfectly fine. I'm just going to mention this now. My Nandu and my Pamphibetes fortis are roughly the same size. Pamphibetes fortis can get a rehouse. That's because Pamphibetes do like to burrow. They have burrowing tendencies. Nandu's not so much. And he's actually attempted to burrow, but obviously can't. So he's getting rehoused. She's just not bothered. She's a mardy bitch. Well, not more, they're very skittish. So yeah, by the way, my Nandu is called Wise. A GBB is called Jezebel. I keep forgetting to give showing the names, but yeah, the GBB is called Jezebel and this one's called Wise. Drop it in, she'll go for it. Yep, always a good feeder. This is why I like Nandu's, one of the best feeders you can get. Well, mine are at least. The hairs are, people said they're the worst hairs, they do not bother me. My Pamphibetes Mac Howler that sadly passed away. That hair's bothered me the most, but that was because it flicked an absolute ton at you. Weren't because they were bad, just flicked loads, but didn't even bother me that bad. So yeah. We'll leave a bay to eat and move on to the next one. Back in a sec. Yeah, as I was saying, he's tried to burrow. This is my Pamphibetes fortis called Logan. He's tried to burrow, so he's getting a tank. It will be that. It'll be the same as my Pamphibetes conceptus. So my Emphis intermedius will be getting one of them as well. Yeah, I'm just going to drop a sound note, we'll go for it. That's just gone into its hide, I'll try and enjoy it. Come on. See what I mean? Just takes straight out the tongs. I'm going to miss this one when he matures, and then we will be going to my female, which sounds quite bad, but I do think she will munch him because she's a bit iffy. Well, she doesn't eat, so it might give him a good chance, because I really hope that the mate and I can keep him, because he's absolutely lovely. He's proper gorgeous, and generally, just really awesome, really nice male, can't complain about him, he looks absolutely stunning. So this is the difference between the adult female and, well, it's an immature male, it'll look a lot different when it matures, but you can even see, the mature female just looks brown, it hasn't really got the colours to the carapace, but this has like a pink tinge to it, pink, purple, bluey, cool blind, so take it however you want. Okay, so I'm just going to leave it be and move on to the next one. Back in a sec. This is my Nandu Colorado Velosis. I don't think she's going to eat. Her abdomen's starting to darken, so fingers crossed she's going to mold. This is one of the ones that I want to actually malt, because she's really fat and I want her to lose some weight so I can actually feed her properly. She's called Blake, is a confirmed female, so both of my Nandus are confirmed females. Let's see if she eats. Oh, bit different. Usually I'm used to. Oh my days. What was that? She actually is in pre-malt. Holy crap. Thank God for that, finally. Yeah, with adults, you definitely know if they're in pre-malt as they turn down food, and every week this one absolutely destroys food. So, yep, it's gonna malt. Cannot wait, because if I'm honest, it's looking scabby as out. So I'll be glad when this malts. Okay, we'll leave it be, I'll move on to the next one. Back in a sec. So, my El Parai Bonner hasn't ate yet. Should have hardened up, so I'm just gonna apply it towards it. Sorry, it's not the best angle, but it's awkward. Nope, she's not hungry. I'm gonna take it out and leave her be. Well, it's a suspect to him, but. Yeah, I'm gonna take it out. Don't stress it out. Okay, I'll leave it be. It has molted, so it's just been hungry. I fed it last week though. Can't remember. Yeah, I think I did a mini feeding video and I fed it. I can't remember off the top of my head. If not, it's just not hungry. Okay, I'll leave it be and move on to the next one. Back in a sec. There's a better shot of my LP. I do like these. One of my favourite tarantulas. Shame, I think it's a male. It is unnamed though, as I've said, so. It is a suspect male though. It just looks to me to be male. Did text the malt, but it was tatty, so it could. It was chewing on it and it was wrecked, so I could be wrong. Okay, I'll leave it be and move on to the next one. Back a sec. This is Mark by B. Bowman. We should eat. I'm very close to maturity now. Next malt he will mature, and I don't think he's in pre malt just yet. Oh. It's very weird at the moment. Very weird. Usually, they want it, it'll just be awkward. What's that? Could be in pre-malt, and that means close to maturity. Bit gutted about that, because he's one of my favourite tarantulas, and he was one of my first tarantula ever. So I'm going to take it out, don't stress him out at all. This is my baby. Yeah. Just got face full of hairs, cheers. Yeah, I'm gonna leave him be. Oh, all the minutes. Okay, I'll leave him be and move on to the next one. Back in a sec. Hiding away, cause she's really skittish. See if we can get. What's the best you can get? Black Saber, my Belmacal Cody's. Captive bred adult female. All my tarantulas are captive bred, just so people know. But yeah. She's been in pre-malt for ages now, she will eventually malt. I'm just going to top up the water and leave her be. There's absolutely nothing wrong with her, she's doing perfectly fine, she'll keep her dry and water bowl, and she's happy. Quite skittish, but not too fussed because she's just nice in general when she's out. She usually sits on the top of there, and when I come near, she just slowly walks into there. Really slow species. So yeah, I'm just going to fill up a water bowl and leave her be. It's been a bit of a naff feeding video this week, but can't predict it. Okay, back in a sec. This is Nightmare, my absolutely gorgeous from Ictopus Concert is. I think it's a male. I'll drop it in, it should absolutely go for it. See what I mean? Straight away. One of the best tarantulas and one of my favourites by far. Absolutely love these. They are my favourite species of tarantula. Just because the attitude and how big they get, because I do like my videos. So yeah, I'll leave it be and move on to the next one. If you didn't know, by the way, my favourite species are from Ictopus, Camphor scuria, even though I only have one, Nandu and Placiodora. So I do like my bird ears. I do also like Sparbotheria hoffmannis a lot, but obviously that's only a single tarantula, so it's not really a species, so I don't really count it. So yeah, I'm just going to fill up his water bowl and move on to the next one. So yeah, that's a nightmare. Okay, I'll leave it be and move on to the next one. Back in a sec. This is Shere Khan, my near adult female sea fasciatum. Usually always hungry, just a bit of an awkward feeling. Like, I know she'll eat, she nearly always does. Just, she doesn't like to eat on camera anymore. She's webbing up a lot. This is my second most pissy tarantula. She might eat on camera. Second pissiest tarantula. Very, very pissy. Oh, and it's took it down. Very, very pissy. Nearly as pissy as my Functus concertus. Very, very close, which is crazy. So it's it's a dwarf species and it just tries to go for you. Gives me fret postures and everything. So yeah. Actually, it on camera. I'll leave it be anyway. Move on to the next one. Back in a sec. This is my Haplopus species, Columbia Large. Should be hungry. Bit of an awkward feeder, honestly. I'll leave her be. I'll come back to you in 5 minutes and she'll be eating it. She's a bit of an odd one. To say that she's webbed up this much and she doesn't burrow and she thinks she's an arboreal. Okay, we'll leave her be and move on to the next one. Back in a sec. Again, I forgot to mention my Haplopus species, Columbia Large, is called Amber. This is Atlas, my Holophele sanguiniceps. Don't think it'll eat on camera. Sorry about that. I'll leave it be, because it's coming out that side, and I know for a fact it'll run up the tank and bolt. Because these are very, very fast and quite a big species for Haplopus. And even to say it's a male, suspect, it's even bigger. So yeah, I'll leave it be and move on to the next one. Back in a sec. This is my Nemphis Intermedius, or Intermediate, depending what you want to use. Very, very nice species. Absolutely gorgeous. These are probably one of my favourite species as well, Memphis. It's very expensive. Should be hungry. This needs an upgrade as well, same as my Pamphibetius fortius. See what I mean? And it's actually out. But look at the leg span of that. Obviously a suspect male. Very skittish. Come on, just like came out for it. An awkward one. Don't want.
doing?
I'm just going to leave it be. It will eat that, I know it for a fact. I'll come back to it in 5 minutes and give you an update. At least we got to see it. Okay, back in a sec. Sorry you won't be able to see too much. The flash is overheated on my phone. I'm just going to chuck it in with this one. I'm just going to chuck it in and leave it be. It's my Lassiodora stratopes and it's unnamed. I need to hurry up now, so I'm just going to rush through these. Okay, back in a sec. This is Sai for my Cochia bunny peas. You're going to see absolutely nothing for this. It's pitch black, and my phone does not want to use its flash. Another one that doesn't want to eat on camera. I'm rushing through these now, I'm sorry, but I feel absolutely awful, but I just want to feed these, and I want to record it. So if they eat, straight away they eat. If not, I'll give an update on them. Tomorrow morning. Okay, I'm gonna leave this one be. Back in a sec. Bye. This is my Sparbuffy half manny called Vulgrim. She'll be hungry. I know you can't see anything, but. Yeah, went for straight away. Sorry about the lighting thing, but I need to hurry up and I can't wait for my phone to cool down, so. Yeah. This is the best you're gonna get. You'll get an update tomorrow on Maelstrom, so yeah. Okay, back in a sec.
Sorry about that. First the flash went, and then I couldn't talk, so that didn't go too well. Most everything's 8, to be fair. Into gold is 8. Aatrox is still eating. Don't lift the late is 8. Puriscal hasn't 8 yet. Amphrosine has an 8. I can't see if that's 8. Anemphis Intermedius is 8. Elf Stratopes is 8. The Holophele Sanguiniceps is 8, I think. Hasn't 8 yet. Pulchrites. Yeah, that's eating. Teocity, I think, is eating as well. I'll give you a proper update in a sec. I'll leave them for a bit and give a double check of what's 8 and show you, and then give an update on other stuff that hasn't 8 tomorrow. But yeah, sorry about that. I will put a disclaimer at the beginning of the video so you'll already know this, but yeah, a bit naff the audio and
But I couldn't talk and flash went, so it looked a bit pale. But yeah, I'll sort that out. Okay, just in a minute, people. Bye.
Okay, I'm going to do this in two lots of updating what's 8. And the Hall of Fame into has an 8, but it hasn't been at its Burrow, to be fair, so I think that will eat. From Ictopus Platus has eaten. I'll just leave that one be. The T Octi has. Yeah, it's eaten. Jupiter Cripes has eaten. It's just left it there because I've startled it, but it has eaten. And Pumpkin Patch has eaten. Looking very fat and big. But yeah. It's eaten. So then what has eaten? I'll give you an update on a couple more back in a sec. Last Theodora Stratipes is 8, Holophelis sanguiniceps is 8, Nymphis intermedius is eaten, and the K Bunipes is eaten. So all them have eaten. I'll just give you an update what hasn't eaten yet. Okay, back in a sec. The only ones I'm left waiting to see if they eat. Avicularia latus probably ate some, but just left a bit because it's only small. Same with the Canthus scuriatrox. It's obvious it's been eating. It jumped it pretty much straight away, and its arse is massive, as you can see. Puris scal hasn't ate yet, but if I'm honest, I don't think it's noticed it because it's just there. But yeah. And the last one is the Acanthus scuria, Gramostola, Anthracaena. I think that might be in pre-molt, to be fair. Oh, and the Holophila incy hasn't ate yet, but that hasn't been out of his burrow, so that could still eat as well. Everything else, if I'm honest, quite a few things seem to be in pre-molt. Klugi's in pre-molt, the Fortis isn't just eaten. Bomir seems to be in pre-molt. Nandu Colorata Velosis seems to be in pre-malt. The Elcock Codis is definitely in pre-malt. So yeah, quite a few big adults in pre-malt. So I can't wait for them to malt. Okay. I'll give an update either tonight or tomorrow morning. Okay, back in a sec. Okay, the Amphastoria Aatrox and later did eat a tiny bit. The Crypodromus Puriscal didn't eat. That's just a centipede. I don't even count that. Gramostola Anthracaena hasn't ate, so probably pre-malt. And Holophila Inti hasn't ate, but could still be hardening up, but I don't know. I'll just leave it be anyway. I'm going to take all these out, and yeah, that's it. So, crap feeding video, but hopefully it'll be better next week. So, bye, people. Bye.